Hello and welcome back. So in this video, let's publish this form so that we can take it to our web page and we see how it appears. So if I click on save, so I'll just come up here and I will say save and publish. So in this case, you can see if you want to take the code yourself, you'll just say, I will install the web form myself. Or if you have someone else who will do this for you, you'll just click here and then you can send them an optional message. Then you put their email address here. Then you send them this message and it will send them that code so that they can put it on your website. Or if you want the form to be hosted on Getresponse, you can just take this link and you'll put it as a link on your website. So the first thing, actually, let's start with this one, whereby we can just add a link so that people subscribe to our form. In that, click on this link and it will take them to the form. So the first one, let me come to my WordPress. Let's say that we want to add it as a link here. So I can just say, click here to join. So in WordPress, if you want to create a new page, you just come into pages and then add new, and then you can create the page that you want to create. So add a link. Let me paste in the link for our Getresponse form, and I want it to open in a new window. So I'll click that. So if somebody clicks here, it's going to take them to our form. So let me publish so I can go and preview and view the page. And if I click on this link, it should take us to our form. And you can see as we put it, it opens in a new window. So this is if you're using WordPress. If you're not using WordPress, you can just do a little bit of HTML. I'm going to show you the HTML in a moment. So you can see that brings us to this form. So let's say that you're not using WordPress. So if I come here, this is a simple HTML that I created for my HTML and CSS tutorial. So if you watch that, you saw me create all of this. So what we want to do, we want to create a link, and you can take the same link, just copy it, put it on your website, and it will work for you as well. So let's say I want to add a link. So what I can do, I'll just come here. Okay, let me add that link after all of this. So if you want to add a link, you use the a tag, a href, and then under the href, within the href here, this is where you add this link. So your link, you'll bring it, you put it inside of the href, and then what you want to be seen, what you want people to see so that they can click and go to your webpage. For example, in my case, it is this one. This is called an anchor text. So if you want your anchor text to say the same thing, so I'll just come here and put it there. And then if I want it to open in a new page, let me add target. And then target will be blank. This will make it open in a new page. So you can just take this. You see the way this is? You can just take this and then put it on your web page. Come here and change your anchor text, what you want it to say. If you want it to say, click here to download, it's entirely up to you. And then here, you'll put in the link of your form, and I've shown you where this link can be acquired from. Also, if you want to learn HTML, I have a very short course on HTML and CSS. you're going to get this full file, HTML file, so that you can just copy this code. And we're going to use this for other examples. So you're going to get it as a resource and you can use it to follow along with me. So if I come back here to the browser and I reload, you can see it is down here. I can just add break tag. At least to add some space beneath it. Control C, Control V, reload. Yeah, so if you see here, if I click this, it will take us to that form. So it brings us to our form. So this is a very simple way for you to just add a form. You don't really have to put it on your site. You can just link to it and it will be hosted by GetResponse. So in the next video, we're going to take this code and put it on WordPress. And we are also going to put it on this HTML so that we can see if it's going to show up, even though this is not online. But I'm just going to show you how you can put it such that it can be displayed on your web page, even if you're not using WordPress. So I will see you in the next video. But just a recap, in this video, we have said that there are different ways in which you can display the form. One of them, which I've demonstrated, is how you can just host the form on GetResponse. You'll just create a link, come here, copy all of this, then link to it. Or you can send it to your web designer, just put their email address here, give them the instruction, send them the message. Or you can add the form yourself. And this is the one we're going to use in the next video. So I will see you in the next video.